Good morning, children. Welcome to the class. In the previous chapter, we have learned about the powerful ideas of freedom and equality that circulated in Europe after the French Revolution. Before the 18th century, society was broadly divided into estates and orders. All the social and economic power was in the hands of the church and the clergy. Suddenly, after the revolution, it was possible to change this. In many parts of the world, including Europe and Asia, new ideas about individual rights were discussed, and who could control the power in the society began to be discussed. These powerful ideas of freedom and equality started circulating in Europe after the French Revolution. In India also, Rajaram Mohan Roy and D'Orozio, who talked about the importance of French Revolution, and many others also debated the idea of post-revolutionary Europe, what could happen after the revolution. These developments in the colonies in turn reshaped these ideas of social change. But not everyone in Europe wanted a complete transformation of society. Some responded well and wished for a gradual shift and accepted that some change was necessary. Some wanted to restructure the society radically. Some were conservatives, some were liberals or radicals. What did these terms really mean at that time? What ideas separated these strands of politics and what linked them together? To reason this and to get answers for these questions, we will look briefly at some important political conditions of the 19th century. And now we will see how they influence the change. Now let us know about liberals, radicals and conservatives. The liberals are one of the groups which look to change the society, and liberals wanted a nation which tolerated all religions. At this time, European state usually discriminated in favor of one religion or another. Britain favored the Church of England, Austria and Spain favored the Catholic Church. And liberals also opposed the uncontrolled power of dynastic rulers who were clergy and nobles. They wanted to safeguard the rights of individuals against government. They argued for a representative of commoners, who elected parliamentary government. Means the government should be subject to laws interpreted by a well-trained judiciary, and that was independent of rulers and officials. They were not democrats. They did not believe in universal adult franchise, that is, the right of every citizen to vote. They felt men of property mainly should have the right to vote. They did not want the vote for women also. But in contrast, radicals who wanted a nation in which government was based on the majority of the country's population, many supported women's suffragette. Suffragette movement means a movement to give women right to vote. They opposed the privileges given to the great landowners and wealthy factory owners. They were not against the existence of private property, but they disliked the concentration of property in the hands of few people who had power or order. Conservatives were opposed to radicals and liberals. After the French Revolution, even conservatives had opened their minds to the need for change. Earlier, in the 18th century, conservatives had been generally opposed to the idea of the change, but by the 19th century, they accepted that some change was inevitable, but and believed that the past had to be respected. Whatever had happened during the revolution or before that, and change had to be brought about through a slow process. Liberals wanted a sudden change. Radicals at some point opposed, and conservatives wanted a slow process of change in the society. Such differing ideas about societal change that clashed during the social and political turmoils or in difficult conditions that followed the French Revolution. Now we will learn about the industrial society and social change. It was a time of profound social and economic changes. It was a time when new cities came up and new industrialized regions developed. Railways expanded and the industrial revolution started occurring. Industrialization thus brought men, women, children to factories. Work hours were very long and the wages were poor. Salaries were not paid well. Unemployment became common, particularly during the times of low demand for industrial goods. There were not enough houses to live in for the people, and the problem of sanitation grew since the towns were growing rapidly. Liberals and radicals searched for solution to all these issues. Most of the industries were the property of individuals, means all the industries and properties were owned by single person. Liberals and radicals themselves were often property owners and employers. When they started making more money, they thought that more benefits could be achieved if the workforce in the economy was healthy. Means if working people were more healthy, then they can work better and get more benefit. And even if they were more educated, then they could earn more. This they believed that in this individual effort rather than the privileges of old practices. They believed in effort, labor and enterprise. If freedom is given to poor that could labor and who had more capital money could work more, even better without any obstacle. They believed that societies could develop like this. Many working men and women who wanted changes in the world rallied around liberal and radical groups and partied in the early 19th century. Some nationalist liberals and radicals, they wanted revolutions to put an end to the kind of these governments which established in Europe in 1815. In France, Italy and Germany and Russia, they became revolutionaries and worked to overthrow existing monarchs. Nationalists talked of the revolutions that could create such nations where all citizens could have equal rights. After 1815, Giuseppe Mazzini, an Italian nationalist, he conspired with others to achieve this in Italy. Nationalists in other countries too, including India, read his writings about these policies. Now coming to the socialism in Europe. What is socialism? Socialism is a political idea that is based on the belief that all people are equal and money and property should be equally divided. And this is one of the most far-reaching visions of how society should be structured. By the mid-19th century in Europe, socialism was a well-known body of ideas that attracted widespread attention. In rest of the countries, socialists are the people who believed in socialism. Socialists were against private property. They saw it as a root of all social ills of the time. Why? Because individuals, a single person who owned the property that gave employment to many people, but the property were concerned only with the personal gain and not with the welfare of those who made the property productive. When the property belonged to the single person who owned it, but not to the workers who worked hard day and night in their factories. So if a society as this was rather single individual who controlled the property and who had more attention would be paid to collective social interest, means it could have been equally divided. Socialists wanted this change and campaigned for it. Socialists had different visions of future also. Some believed in the idea of cooperatives. And what is cooperative? Cooperative is things done by people working together, or a business or an organization that is owned or run by all the people who work for it. Robert Owen was a leading English manufacturer. He sought to build a cooperative community called New Harmony in Indiana, in USA. Other socialists felt that cooperatives could not be built on a wide scale, only through individual initiative. They demanded that governments should encourage cooperatives. In France, Louis Blanc wanted the government to encourage cooperatives and replace capitalist enterprises. These cooperatives were to be associations of people who produce goods together and divided the profits according to the work done by the members. Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels added other ideas of arguments. Marx argued that industrial society was capitalist. Capitalist means who had money or capital. Capitalists owned the capital invested in factories, and the profit of capitalist was produced by the own workers. The condition of the workers could not improve as long as the profit was accumulated by private capitalist. Workers had to overthrow capitalism and the rule of private property. Marx believed that workers who wanted to free themselves from the capitalist exploitation had to construct a radically socialist society where all the property was socially controlled. This could be a communist society. He was convinced that workers could gain victory over the problem with the capitalist. A communist society was the national society of the future. And the communists are the person who believes in or supports communism. And who are communist society? And what is communist society? Communism is a political system in which the state owns or controls all the factories, farms and services and aims to treat everyone equally. And support for the socialism. By the 1870s, these socialist ideas spread throughout the Europe. To coordinate their efforts, socialists formed an international body that was intergovernmental organization, that is established by a treaty or an agreement to other governments, and namely it was the Second International. Workers in the England and Germany also began forming associations to fight for a better living and working condition. They set up funds to help the members in times of difficulties and demanded a reduction of working hours and the right to vote. In Germany, these associations work closely with the Social Democratic Party, that is SPD, and helped it to win parliamentary results. By 1905, socialist and trade unionist formed a Labour Party in Britain and Socialist Party in France. Unionists were the members of trade union. However, till 1914, socialists never succeeded in forming a government in Europe that was represented by a strong figures in parliamentary politics, and their ideas did shape the legislation, but the agreements continued to run by the conservatives, liberals and radicals. And this was all about socialism. In the next class, we will learn about Russian Revolution.